Hi folks, this is Peach Mario. It's a short introduction video about the Unilink plugin. There is some information about why this plugin, or why I did make the plugin. In the Google groups there have been several discussions about linking mechanism with captions and with subtitles and aliases and so on. So there is some description about the history. Yeah. And then we have some getting started with the basic information about how to use the plugins. There is one button which lets you create example titlers, so you can play with them. I just say save, 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 so that they are created. Yeah, then we will have a closer look. We don't need this anymore. There is a titler now which is called Test Links, and it tests all the links so you can see them. This is a default link, a default pretty link, where we have the text which is displayed and the titler title which is linked to. There is no change to this behavior. So this is the same everywhere. Then in a normal titler wiki, where you have a link like this, titler with caption, you would see here titler with caption. But with the plugin, it shows a short title. It uses the caption field that we are used to for a table of content and for lists and the right sidebar. So this is the caption. The next one is a caption with subtitle. In the discussion group, someone used the caption for a longer text. But by design, this makes problems because of lists. So that's why we defined a new field here, which is called subtitle. So if the subtitle field is present, it will be used, and it also takes precedence. So if subtitle and caption both are there, the subtitle will win. Yeah, since we changed the basic or the standard behavior, we also need to have a possibility to disable it. And this is done with the pipe at the end. As you can see it here, there is a pipe which just lets you create a link like this. Even if you have a caption or a subtitle, it just shows the titler link. Then here we have a titler that doesn't exist. Behavior that we know already. As you can see, there are different colors. So we have some styles in the plugin. We open the plugin. There should be, is it styles here. There is a styles titler which defines Unilink, Unilink caption, Unilink subtitle, Unilink alias. So you can basically define a different color for every element, which I think is quite handy, so you can directly see if it is a caption or a subtitle or an alias or something like that. Okay, then there is the alias syntax. It's this one. It allows us to define, it allows us to define a white space separated list that we know already from the tags. So I can define a new alias here, alias with spaces, for example, and if I want to use it, I just type alias with spaces pipe and the question mark, and it creates a link. The nice thing about those alias links is they are not case sensitive. So if I write alias with spaces like this, it still links to the right titler. So only this alias is important, and they are not case sensitive. This also makes it possible that you change the titler title. Test X, I don't know. Now it's test X. And the link works. Yeah. So that's one part. The other part is with the AKA macro that I created, it was not possible to get backlinks. Yeah. But now with the Unilink plugin, every tiddler, if we open the info area, has a reference information, and this displays links, and here are the aliases. So if you open the alias tiddler, it gets test links here. Yeah? So these are standard links and these are alias links. Yeah, very powerful, I think. It gives us some backlinks. What else is there? In the right sidebar, we have a new more tab. There is something which is called aliases. They are sorted by aliases, so you get all the aliases, and below are the different tiddlers where they are used, or they are sorted by tiddler title and the aliases are shown. So for example, there is Darwinism has several elements. There should be an example tiddler, which gives you different possibilities how you can write it. Yeah, one known issue at the moment is camel case links. Yeah, so if you use, let's say, a word like this, it will have some trouble. Yeah? But there is some, I think there is an internal problem. We have to have a closer look at this one. So this is a known issue at the moment. What else do we have? In the control panel, we have a short, small configuration tiddler where you can define if you want to see the footer. So every tiddler that has aliases field automatically gets this new footer, and you can enable and disable it if you want. What else? I think there are some other tiddlers. You can play with them, then you will see what happens. Why is it needed? I think I did cover the basic. If I reload it, I'll go back to the getting started. There are some elements now, some filter operators, which I added, which makes life a lot easier. There is one which is called is alias and all aliases. Yeah? So for example, if I copy this one to the advanced search filter, and finish the filter expression, then you can see the list like this. Yeah? So there are two of them at the moment which I needed for the application, is alias and all aliases. Okay, yeah, I think I covered everything. I hope you like it and have fun.